We'll start in a lovely seated position. So whatever feels good to you, you can come into a cross-legged position, or you can sit like how I like to, sitting back on your heels. You can position a cushion underneath your hips to help make it comfortable. And we'll just begin with some pranayama or breath control. So closing the eyes, seeing if you can add here a little length to your spine. So just feel a gentle drawing up through the crown of the head. And then begin to turn your attention to your breath. And we'll simply observe the breath. For a few rounds, see how easily it is coming into the body and truly satisfying you. So notice if as you inhale, you do have that feeling that you have been recharged with some fresh oxygen. And as you exhale, do you feel that you're truly letting go of all of the air in your lungs and your belly, everything that needs to go outside of the body in that exhale breath? After a few rounds of watching, we turn this unconscious action into something that is very much conscious by deepening and lengthening the breath. As you deepen, you might notice more how the belly expands with breath and how the lungs fill, particularly in the back body, feeling the lungs expand with breath there. And then the breath arrives in the upper chest. And then as you let the breath go through the nose, you feel that breath leaves the belly, it deflates, and then the lungs empty of air, and it leaves the body again via the upper chest. After a few rounds of that beautiful deep breathing, let's come to a form of pranayama that is sometimes called skull cleansing breath or kalabhati breath. So here we will be doing short and sharp exhalations so that the inhalation happens basically immediately after the exhalation without you having to put any effort or control into that part of the breath. You can imagine sort of like a dog panting, and these breaths are coming out through the nose. Don't worry if it does send a little bit of whatever is in the nostrils outward as well. I can't see you. So we take a big breath in to begin, and then short and sharp exhales. Keep going with that. It might help to also bring a palm to the belly, and you can feel that beating, that pumping of the breath outward. I'm getting a little bit of nose gunk myself. All right. So stop there. When you finish, take a deep breath in again and a deep breath out. Feel that cleansing action, and then we'll go one more time. So breathing in, Kalabhati breath. Again, deep breath in. And let it out. And just feel now with a few regular inhalations the effect of that pranayama practice. Maybe you feel a little bit lighter. And it's with that energy that we will flutter the eyes open and bring ourselves up to a standing position. So taking your time here in as many movements as you need to arrive standing. And when you arrive standing, bring the feet about hip distance apart, soften your kneecaps, ground down through the heels and balls of the feet. Feel your arches rising away from the mat. And then with an inhale breath, we draw our arms up and overhead. Interlace your fingers here and then flip the grip so that the palms are pushing up towards the ceiling. Take a big breath in, and then as you breathe out, lean over to the right hand side. Now we're really grounding down through the left edge of your, the left edge of your left foot, and then draw your left shoulder back, your right shoulder forward. Deeply stretching here. Really try and send the left hip away from you while you're bringing that right rib down towards the right hip. Inhale, come through the center line. Soften your elbows. Exhale as you flow in the other direction over now to the left-hand side. And we're drawing our right shoulder back, our left shoulder forward, ground down through the right edge of your right foot. Really let the full stretch come into your side body and then inhale back to center. Changing that grip around again and then sending the arms down by your side. Then as we inhale, palms facing down to the ground, we'll lift our arms so that our wrists come in line with our shoulders. And then turning the palms to face one another. Imagine this is a thick energy field between those hands. So it's like you want to pull them all the way together, but you're resisting a little bit. From here, take a breath in, and then as you exhale, draw your left arm backwards, all the way behind you. Keep your hips pointing forward and relax the shoulders down away from the ears. So a lovely spinal twist. Kneecaps are soft. And then we come the other way. So left arm comes in to meet the right. Again, create that little energy force field between the palms. And then we'll inhale as we expand and open over to the right hand side. Really trying to draw those hands in line with one another while the hips stay pointing forward. And you can take your gaze as well over your right shoulder if you like to deepen that twist. And then back to center. We'll turn this into more of a flowing action, taking the arms by the side. So inhale, arms lift, gaze lifts, interlace your fingers, exhale here. And then inhale, stretch up to the ceiling. Exhale as we lean over to the right. Inhale through the center. Exhale, lean over to the left. Inhale to the center, look to the ceiling. Exhale, float the hands down to your sides. Inhale as the arms lift, palms facing down, elbows are relaxed. Exhale, turn the palms to face one another. Inhale as you stretch open with that left arm. Exhale as you draw that arm back to the other. Inhale as you stretch open with that right arm. Exhale. Draw back to the center. Inhale here. And then exhale, float the hands back down to your sides. One more time. So inhale, lift the arms, lift your gaze. Interlace your fingers, flip your grip. Reach up on your next inhale breath. Exhale, leaning over to the right, a little further maybe this time. Elbows are soft. Inhale through center. Exhale and lean over to the left. Inhale, center. Flip the grip again and then exhale, float the hands down to your sides. Inhale as we lift the wrists up in line with the shoulders. Exhale, energy ball in the center there. And then inhale as you twist open with your left hand. exhale as you draw those arms back together, and then inhale, twist open with your right hand. And then exhale as you draw those arms back together. Inhale here, shoulders down away from the ears, and then exhale, release the arms. We'll add one more movement to that flow and then repeat it one more time. We'll practice a few of these, another form of pranayama or a breath combined with action called breath of joy. So we inhale and lift the arms up above the head. And then as you exhale, let it forcefully out with a ha sound. So ha as you come down. Again, inhale, reach up. Exhale, ha. Inhale, up you come. Now as you come down, bend your knees. Ha. Next time you can, if you like, rise all the way up onto the tippy toes. Inhale here. Exhale, ha. Doesn't matter how loud or energetic you get. In fact, the more energetic, ha, the better. Let's go for one more. Ha. And inhale, rise up, lift the arms. Exhale, float them down to your sides. Final round of all of those actions. So inhale, lift the arms, lift the gaze, interlace your fingers. Exhale here. Inhale, turn the grip on those palms. Exhale, leaning into the right. Inhale, coming through center, and then exhale, leaning to the left. Inhale to center, reverse the grip again. Exhale, float the hands down to your sides. Inhale, lift the arms, zombie arms. Exhale, turn the palms to face one another. Inhale, big stretch, open through to the left-hand side. Exhale, sweep those arms back together, energy field here. Inhale, big stretch, open with the right hand, looking over the right shoulder. And then exhale, sweep back together here. Inhale, lift the arms all the way up. Exhale, ha. Stay down here. So keep the knees really bent, so much so that your belly can come to rest on the top of your thighs. Bring your elbows into your hands for a moment. Tuck the chin in towards the chest. And after all of that quite energetic movement that really liberates the spine, we want to keep that liberation, that mobility traveling downward. We open through the thoracic and through our shoulders. Now let's think about that lumbar spine here. So you might sway a little from side to side. Really tuck the chin in towards the chest so that you can release the back of the neck. Maybe closing the eyes, just enjoying how this feels in the body for a moment. Ragdoll position. And let's take one more big breath in here, big breath out, and releasing the elbows. So we're in our regular forward fold position. We'll inhale as we roll back up, one vertebrae at a time, shoulders coming onto the back. Inhale, arms lift, gaze lifts, and then exhale, folding all the way forward again, bending at the knees as you do. Chin tucking in towards the chest. This time as you inhale, looking up, so we're pulling now our chest up a little bit away from our legs on our inhale, but keeping the knees bent. So we're not finding our regular halfway lift. We're about here. And then as you exhale, send your hips down towards the mat. So soften the knees even more. This is helpful for that mobility that I set for a challenge yesterday. As the hips come down towards the floor, find your deepest possible squat position or your little crouch here. And then inhale, lift the hips again. Find this time a full halfway lift. So the legs lengthen, the palms can come to rest on the shins or the upper thighs or fingertips to the earth, just so long as you can have a flat back position, lengthen the back of your neck. Then exhale, fully fold. Inhale as you ripple the spine up to standing, lift the arms, lift the gaze, and we'll do that again. So exhale, hinge at the hips, bend at the knees, fold all the way forward. Inhale, without bending the knees, look up. Look forward, slightly, not all the way up. Still keep the neck long. And then exhale, crouch into this position, sink your hips. Inhale, rise back up, this time to a full halfway lift. Exhale, bend at the knees, fold all the way forward. Inhale, rise all the way to standing, arms lift, gaze lifts. Let's do that one more time. Exhale, folding all the way forward, knees bend, chin into chest. Inhale, lengthen the arms and the spine, but leave the legs bent, and then exhale, crouch position. Inhale, lengthen the legs, arms and spine. Halfway lift, exhale, fully fold. Inhale, rise up to standing, lift the arms, lift the gaze. Exhale, hands to heart. Let's just pause here for a moment and just see how the body's feeling after the practice that we've already completed. Maybe your spine is feeling a little freer. Maybe you have a little bit more energy in the body. I've got some quite dancey music playing in the background for me, so I'm being a bit inspired by that as well. Feel your heart beating. And then we move on. We'll continue energizing the body. So inhale, arms lift, gaze lifts. Exhale, hinge at the hips, folding all the way forward. Again, knees are generously bent here as we do our first forward fold. And then as we come to halfway lift, lengthen arms, lengthen spine, lengthen legs. And then exhale, plant your palms now to the mat. Step one foot behind you, followed by the other. And then lower your knees, lower your chest, and lower your chin. So that all happens in one exhale breath. On your inhale, let's find baby cobra. So pressing the tops of the feet into the earth, pressing through your palms either side of your chest, and just lifting, hovering just above the mat. So we're creating an extension through the spine. Watch that the shoulders didn't hunch up by the ears. Relax them down. On your next exhale, we'll tuck our toes under. Push through the palms, lift the hips, the pelvis first, and then pike your hips up and find your first downward dog position. From here, you can just pedal out through the feet. So one beautiful calf stretch at a time, waking up the back of the legs. Check in with your shoulders here that you're creating a bit of an external rotation. So imagine you want to show your biceps to somebody behind you. Check that your neck is still nice and long, that you're pressing down through your palms, and that you're really allowing yourself to melt your chest back towards your legs. So there's a real letting go, softening action there. Kneecaps are soft. Sit bones are lifted. And then from here, very energizing, particularly in waking up our core, we will move from downward dog into our plank position, forward and back a few times. So on an inhale breath, lead with the crown of the head. So start that journey forward. As the crown of the head moves forward, you'll feel your shoulders are also shifting forward. And we want to stop the shoulders once they're in line with our wrists. Then your hips are coming down from that highest point of the triangle until your body's in a straight line. Now, if you want to practice rolling over your toes, it's a good time here to make a little adjustment with your legs. Maybe send them out a little bit longer so that you're just on the tippy toes. Inhale, breath here in plank, really push the floor away with the palms, and then exhale, pike the hips back up to the ceiling, melt your heart backwards. So you might notice that after doing that once and finding that setup, you had to move your feet a little further away from your hands. It helps you to find your downward dog ideal placement of feet and hands. Let's go again. So inhale, breath, crown of the head shifts first, elbows are soft, shoulders come in line with the wrists, hips come down, plank position. Exhale, breath, pike the hips, push back. And now you can flow between these two in your own time. Feel the activation through the core. So as you exhale and push back to downward dog, the belly button pulls towards the back of the spine. And we keep that same activation while we're in that plank position. We're not collapsing down through the belly, keeping the body lovely and strong. Feel how the shoulders work to maintain that integration across the back of the body. So again, we're not slumping down when we're in plank But we are softening when we are in downward dog. Once more, into plank, big inhale breath here. And then as we exhale, we'll lower down to the mat. And we'll have an option here to try doing that through our chaturanga. So to do that, we'll come all the way forward onto the tippy toes. And as we breathe out, start to lower the chest down between the hands, sending the elbows to graze your sides. So slowly, 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 hang here for a moment. And then push back up. Ooh, it's not easy. Let's do that a few more times. So big inhale, breath, exhale, feel the elbows graze the sides, come halfway down, and then push back up. Once more. And this time come all the way down. So collapsing onto the belly, not collapsing, you should never collapse, softening onto the belly, and then making a pillow here with your palms, resting your forehead, wiggle your hips side to side for a moment. We'll come up now into a few different variations of our spinal extension. We practiced baby cobra before. Let's see if we can find a high cobra together. So first bringing your hands around again in line with your chest. So thinking about the nipple line on the body. That's where we want our palms to be in line with. You'll feel as you press the palms into the mat, your elbows are possibly winging out a little bit. Really try and tuck the elbows in towards the midline of the body. And then tilt your pubic bone down into the mat. On your next inhale breath, spinal extension, pushing through the palms, start to lift. Now you might stop here in baby cobra, or you might be able to carry on up to a high cobra. So that's where we've lifted the body into a deeper spinal extension, and you're lifting all the way up into, all the way down, into the belly, coming away from the mat as well. Hold here for a few breaths, extend the length of the neck. And you can always stick with the lower, the baby cobra down here, if your spine doesn't feel happy about this morning, or whenever you're completing this practice. One more breath in, and then exhale, coming down. And let's just pause for a moment, make that little pillow again, and just let the feet flow from side to side, releasing through the back. Again, coming into a spinal extension, this time with the option to take it all the way into our upward dog. So we'll press the palms again, either side of the chest. Inhale, breath, pushing the floor away with those hands. Feeling the shoulder blades squeeze together in the back as the elbows are tucked in by your side. And this time, you can press into the tops of the feet and just feel the hips really still driving down towards the mat. There's a lot of strength required in the legs here to hold this position. Elbow creases are pointing forward, shoulders are relaxed down away from the ears. One more big breath in here, and then as we exhale, coming back into our downward dog, so the hips piked back up towards the ceiling. Soften through your kneecaps. And for a moment, we'll just all come into a child's pose position, so lowering the knees down, pushing the hips back towards the heels, melting the forehead, the heart down towards the mat. And you can accentuate the C curvature in the spine here to counteract that extension that we've done, creating a flexion in the spine if you want, by drawing belly button to the back of the spine, chin in towards the chest, bringing the hands in and trying to bring the crown of the head closer to the mat. Oh, just a few breaths here again, noticing how the body feels after all of this energizing movement. And we keep moving on. So now going between the downward dog and that upward dog position. I'll show you how you can get there. Well, I'll speak. You'll come with me at the same time. So bringing the hands back forward in our child's pose. We inhale, push through the palms, pike the hips, find our downward dog. And we've already practiced going forward to plank. So on an inhale, let's do that again. Lead with the crown of the head. Bring the shoulders in line with the wrists. Maybe a small adjustment on the feet if you needed to bring yourself onto the tippy toes there. And then this time, instead of lowering down chaturanga style, we'll just keep ourselves lifted on the hands and come straight into an upward dog. So hips are coming down towards the mat. And then we push away from the floor, pike the hips, back into our downward dog. Now, if this isn't serving your body, it doesn't feel very nice, you are more than welcome to just take some time out in child's pose, take some time out in downward dog, whatever feels good for you. Otherwise, this can be a really nice flow. Just to bring more energy into the core, into the spine. Let's do one more. Inhale, ripple forward plank. Exhale, lower the hips. Inhale, pike the hips. Exhale, melt the heart, downward dog. Now on an inhale, we'll take our right foot forward between the hands. And for some people that happens really easily. For some, it might be that you have to lower your back knee to bring your right foot forward. Or you might need to pick it up and place it there. So do whatever it takes for you to arrive with the right foot between the hands. And then everyone's going to lower the back left knee anyway. Uncurl that back foot, or you can keep it tucked under, whatever feels best for you. Check the right knee stacked over the right ankle. And then on an inhale, finding your balance, we'll lift our arms into our low lunge position. Let's take this low lunge and turn it into a twisted lunge. So first we inhale energy up towards the sky. And then as we exhale, bringing the hands forward, we plant our left palm to the mat. And then inhale, twisting open to the right. So we're drawing the fingertips in line with one another, shifting the gaze up towards the ceiling. And drawing here your right rib cage back and your left rib cage forward. So a true twist through the torso. Big breath in here again. And then exhale, drawing that right hand back down to the mat. Again, we'll inhale, lift the arms. So second time finding balance here. This time as we exhale, we'll draw an imaginary bar down behind the head, opening here our heart space up to the ceiling, maybe driving a little further forward into that left hip flexor, and really starting to send the back of the head backward. So it's a heart opener, it's a back bend, it is hard to maintain. One more breath in, and then exhale. Bring both hands forward to frame that front foot. Press the palms into the mat, come onto the ball of that back foot, and then pike the hips and send the right foot to meet the left. So we're back in our downward dog position. Anytime you need to take child's pose instead, you're more than welcome to. Otherwise, we'll take three deep breath here in downward dog before we change sides. So on an inhale, we're now taking our left foot forward between the hands. However you need to arrive there, left knee stacked over the left ankle. And as we exhale, we'll lower our right knee, uncurl the foot. If that feels nice for you, I like it. And then we inhale, find our balance, rise into our regular low lunge. Remember that energy field I talked about at the beginning? Find it again here. And then exhale as the hands come forward to touch down, right palm presses into the mat. Inhale, twist open to the left. Now we're drawing our left rib cage back, our right rib cage forward, looking up to the ceiling. One more breath in here. And then exhale, just briefly tapping down with that left hand before you inhale again, rising into your low lunge. Let's turn it into a crescent lunge. So as we exhale, tuck the tailbone under and then think about driving slightly forward through the front of the right hip flexor and draw that imaginary bar down behind your head, squeeze the shoulder blades together, opening your heart. If this doesn't feel nice with the arms, you can keep them how they were. Two options there. It's not easy. It's really invigorating, but it's also very vulnerable to be in this position. So you might be like, oh, I want to get out. One more breath in and then exhale. There you go. Hands come to touch down. And then let's come onto the ball of that right foot. Pick up the left foot, send it out to meet the right. So again, you might find that as we transition between sides or between rounds of our standing poses, you'd prefer to take child's pose, and also that you might prefer to come into the poses from child's pose or even from standing. You can really make this practice your own. I will show you an option to come in from child's pose for this round. Just know that when I say right foot forward, you could do it from downward dog. But just so you have an idea. So if we're coming from child's pose into our next round here where we are finding high lunge, we would bring the right foot forward between the hands still with the left knee kneeling. So you can see it's a little bit easier to create that shape. Tucking the left foot under this time so that we can find our high lunge. We'll check that we have our right knee stacked over our right ankle and then pop that knee up off of the ground. Of course, those who came from downward dog, that knee will already be lifted. Find your balance, steadiness here. And then on an inhale, lifting the arms, high lunge. Again, find that energy force field between the hands. Relax the shoulders down away from the ears. Tuck your tailbone under. Notice how that naturally drops your back knee a little further down towards the mat. Big inhale here. Exhale as the hands come forward. Just gently touching that left palm to the mat. And then inhale, twisted high lunge. Again, think about the rib cage. Right ribs back, left ribs forward. Keep pushing that left ball of the foot into the mat, creating this spiraling action here. One more breath in and then exhale, touching down just briefly. Find the balance again. Inhale, ooh, up before you come. High lunge. Now, if you like, you can take a crescent shape here. It is really challenging. So on an exhale breath, you'll be drawing that imaginary bar down behind your head, trying to shift your gaze to the ceiling, trying to send the left hip flexor slightly forward, really bend into that knee and open your heart. One more breath in and exhale, down we go, touch down. Send that right foot back to meet the left. So I'll come in from downward dog this time, but just those people who do need to take child's pose, continue with that, please. Few breaths here. And then we'll change sides. Left foot coming forward between the hands. On an inhale, we'll bring ourselves into that high lunge. Energy field between the palms, tailbone tucked under. One more breath in, and then as we exhale, take the hands down to frame that front foot. Plant the right palm, inhale, twist open to the left. Left ribs draw back, right ribs draw forward. One more breath in, and then exhale, take that hand down just briefly. Inhale, coming back up, finding the balance, lifting the gaze. Exhale, opening into our crescent high lunge. Really think about someone pulling a string to open through the chest. Squeeze the shoulder blades together in the back. One more breath in, and then exhale. Down we come. Send the left foot to meet the right. Take a few breaths here. I'm just going to check on my time. I want to make sure that we don't go too long. Ooh, time flies when you're having fun, right? Okay, we've got one more standing flow.
So this time, right foot comes forward between the hands. And we want to plant the heel of the back foot. So just swivel a little on the ball, lower the heel down. So the foot's at about a 25-degree angle. And our heels are either a little further apart from one another to accommodate the hips, or the heels might come into alignment, though that can be quite tricky. So just see what feels good in the lower body here. Check that you've still got that line from right knee down to right ankle, and then on an inhale, lift the arms. So we're finding warrior one. We're checking here that the hips are facing that short edge of the mat, and that's where you might need to make adjustments on the feet to find your happy place in this position. Take a big breath in here, and then as you exhale, swing your arms around behind you, interlace your fingers, push heels of the palms together, and then squeeze the shoulder blades together. So we're opening up across the heart space once again. One more breath in, and then as you exhale, look to the top left corner of your mat and start to bow. So chin coming in towards the chest, opening up more through the shoulders. We call this humble warrior. And we don't want to use our right leg as a shape. We're really coming out to the left-hand side. It's not an easy position. You really need to ground down through your feet. Push so hard it's like you want to draw the mat apart. And your humble warrior might be more like up here. And that is just fine. You need to go to your own body's edge. We call it the edge, the place where you can really feel the challenge of the pose, but without pushing so far against that edge that we feel real pain or something that our body can't tolerate. And you need to learn to trust your intuition when it comes to being guided as to what is your edge in each pose. Chin really tucking in towards the chest, so to lengthen the neck. One more breath in, breath out. And then we'll inhale, rise back up into our warrior one. Really draw that left hip forward if it sunk backwards. We'll come from here into our standing split position. So big breath in, and then as you exhale, take the hands down to the mat to frame your front foot. Come up right onto the tippy toe of your left foot. And then you can use blocks here to lengthen your arms or some books, whatever you've got at home. Bend through your right knee so it's very bent. And as you do that, lift your left foot up towards the sky. And we're thinking about the heel of that left foot lifting so that the hips are staying square. As you lengthen the left leg, you might be able to find more length through the right, drawing the chin in towards the shin. Maybe you can balance a little more by drawing your right arm around the back of the shin here. And we're really trying to fold the upper body over the lower. One more beautiful breath in here, breath out. And then we'll swing that left leg all the way through. Find your balance. Think about that crouch position from earlier. Lifting your fingers, lifting your knee out front. Pause here for a moment. I know that right leg's feeling a lot of intense strength work, but you can do it. Soften the kneecap, round down into the mat. Don't worry if you lost balance and you had to come back in. Knee is in line with the hip on that left leg. Option if you want, just to extend that leg out long for a moment. Think tall through the crown of the head. One more breath in and then bring it down. And we'll take a wee pedal out. Vinyasa over to the other side. Inhale, arms lift, gaze lifts. Exhale, hinge at the hips, folding all the way forward. Inhale, find that halfway lift. Exhale, planting your palms, making your way down to the mat so you can step, float your feet to plank, lower down, chaturanga, or knees, chest, chin. Inhale, finding your back bend. And then exhale, back into downward dog. And you know where we're going now. This is the last of our standing work. So inhaling as the left foot comes forward between the hands. And then lowering the heel of that right foot, thinking about drawing the right hip forward so that the hips are square to that front edge, that short edge of the mat, and then rising.
Finding Warrior One. Left knee is bent so that the knee is stacked over the ankle. There's a spiraling action here where it's like you want to show your right inner thigh to somebody behind you. That helps to rotate that hip forward. One more breath in here, energy upward. And then exhale, hands coming down behind the back, interlace your fingers. Inhale as you push heels of the palms together, squeeze the shoulder blades together and puff up the chest. And then looking now to the top right corner of the mat, and we start to fold. So think here how strong you have to be through this left leg. Just watch that knee doesn't come out to either side, keep it stacked over the ankle. As you fold, draw the chin into the chest, lengthen the back of the neck and then open up through your shoulders as well. Keep pushing down through your feet, try and push them apart from one another, especially through the outer edge of your right foot. Pull your lower belly in. And keep breathing here. Really form up through that left inner thigh. Don't forget about that right glute, that right inner thigh. Keep spiraling. That same action that we were doing earlier. One more breath in. Breath out. And then
inhale. Rise all the way back up to Warrior One. Draw that right hip forward. And then coming into our standing split on this side. Big breath in. Exhale. Hands come down to frame that front foot. As we inhale, let's send the body weight forward onto the left foot as the right foot lifts. Knee is generously bent in that left foot. So again, it's like a crouching action that we already started practicing at the beginning. And then you can expand with an inhale breath, really kicking that right foot up behind you. Keeping the hips square, think about the heel driving up towards the ceiling. We don't need to point the toe to begin. And keeping that right hip from lifting up and open, really draw it downward. Now, you might have different range on each side. I certainly do. My left leg is not very stretchy through the hamstring. So just be kind to yourself about your range on either side. Maybe extending the balance challenge by taking your left hand to the back of your left leg. Keep driving up towards the ceiling. One more breath in here. And then exhale, let's draw that right knee all the way through. Keep that crouching action. Try not to touch it down. Lift the fingertips, lift the leg out in front. One-legged Tadasana or Mountain Pose. Knees in line with the hip here. Arms are by the side. Feel that energy, that shift in energy. Shoulders up, back and down. If you like, you can practice pointing that foot outward. And down it comes. Take a wee pedal out. Well done. We will come down to the mat now. So through a squat position, inhale, lift the arms, lift the gaze. Exhale, press the palms, hands draw down to the heart. And then we start to drop through the hips, just like you're sitting down into a chair, trying to keep those knees back. Weight in the heels until we come all the way down. Whew. Couple of positions here while we're seated. So let's extend our right leg out long. And we'll bend our left knee, flex that right foot. First, we're going to come into a cradle baby position. If it's a real struggle seated, you could try it laying down on your back. So first we pick up the foot on the left leg and we're trying to pull that foot into the elbow crease on the right arm. Once you've got that, we're taking the elbow around the knee and cradling this leg like it is a baby. And we're just sending that hip stretch into the left hip flexor. And you can take little movements here, whatever feels good. Think about sitting up tall through the crown of the head. And if you couldn't achieve that action, an option is to just work here without the foot being right into that elbow crease. And one more breath in.
And then as we exhale, let's plant that foot down, having taken it across to the other side of that extended right leg. And first a twist. So inhale, lift that right arm to the sky. And then as you exhale, you can either again find knee in the elbow crease and twist around to the left, or you might be able to take the outer edge of your elbow to create some extra traction here to twist over to the left. We're looking over that left shoulder. As we inhale, extending the spine up tall, and as you exhale, twisting deeper. Again, think about your rib cage here that twists through the torso, so the right rib's drawing back, the left rib's drawing forward. One more breath in, and then exhale, unravel, unwind. Keep this foot where it is, but now we want to try and send the leg even further over the midline, drawing the left heel towards the outside edge of our right butt cheek. And the goal here is to try and bring the knees as much into alignment as possible, so into our half shoelace pose. And once you've found this position, we'll deepen the stretch through our left hip flexor by also taking a stretch over to the right-hand side. So bringing your fingertips down in line with the hip and hopefully the toes on that left foot. And then we inhale and stretch up and over here. Keep flexing and activating through that right foot. Draw the left shoulder back, the right shoulder forward, and we should feel a yummy stretch through this part of the body. One more breath in, breath out, and then we'll inhale, bring ourselves all the way up. Uncross that leg, and as you come through the middle, just let your thighs turn to jelly for a second, and then we'll change sides. So flexing, activating through that sole of the left foot, bending the right leg, really hugging it as close in towards you as you can, and then trying that scoop, so elbow connect, inside of the elbow connecting to the outside of the knee, and then picking up. And of course, it's not to worry if you can't get the foot into the elbow crease. You can work here. We just want to find a little massage into that hip crease that feels good. If you can connect into your cradle baby pose, then do that. And just some little micro movements. And in these movements, it might feel nice to close the eyes, focus on what's happening. Where do you need a little extra movement? Where do you need a little extra hold? Explore the joint, explore how the movements feel in your body. We're not mindlessly just sort of rocking the leg forward and back. It's a truly explorative action and something you only you can do for yourself. I can't guide you through this. After one more deep breath in here, deep breath out, we'll lower the sole of that right foot over to the outside edge of that left leg. And then an inhale breath as we lift that left hand to the ceiling. Exhale as you cuddle the right leg with that left arm, and then taking your hand behind your hip on that right-hand side and using that leverage you have between the leg and the arm to twist behind you. Maybe the elbow can come into play here. But again, only if it feels good. Inhale, lift up tall through the spine. Exhale, twist. Again, inhale, lift up tall. Exhale, twist. And then unravel, unwind. Let's come into that half shoelace on this side. Remembering again, two sides of the body are different. This one's a real challenge for me, and it's so easy to get frustrated. But try to just be curious about what's going on in your body. We'll see if we can bring our knees closer towards alignment and the heel of that Right foot now getting closer in towards the butt cheek there on that left-hand side. And then once we've come into this position with the legs, stay grounded through the sit bones, taking your fingertips now in line with the hip on that left-hand side, and then a big inhale. And let's stretch up and overhead, palm facing down towards the mat. Nice stretch through the right hip flexor now. Really try and melt into this position. One more big breath in. And let that breath go. And then we'll inhale. Coming back to upright, uncrossing that leg there. And then beautiful timing. Let's roll all the way down into onto our backs. So kneecaps are soft and just gently guiding the body downward one vertebrae at a time until the shoulders find rest on the mat. And we'll keep the knees bent just for the moment so that we can come into a final little back bend here, and I don't want it to be a deep one. So heels are coming in towards the bottom, and let's lift our toes. So we're just pushing into the heels. Arms are by the sides, the knees are drawing in towards one another, but not pressing, sorry. You've still got that little force field between the knees, keeping them hip distance apart. Inhale, breath here. And then as you exhale, just peel the hips up off of the mat. And they won't come up very far because we're just pushing into our heels. I only want that small distance here being created. And just feel here how it is to lift that lumbar portion of the spine without extending much deeper or further into this back bend. And you can here as well add a little intuitive movement. So maybe the knees sort of fall to the left or to the right. Keeping those toes lifted. Can turn into a little dance almost. One more breath in. Really arch up and then exhale. Highest portion of the spine to the lowest. Come down into the mat. And now you take your Shavasana position. So however you like, maybe traditional with the legs coming out long, feet falling apart from one another, arms by your side, palms facing up. Maybe you want to take an inversion. That's in your practice. So headstand, shoulder stand, or simply the legs up the wall or lifted up into the air. And I want you to feel free to stay in your Shavasana, your resting pose, for as long as you would like. And we're doing our best here just to keep our focus, our attention on melting down, on relaxing, on surrendering. I'll go ahead and stop the live recording now. But do feel free to remain here as long as you need. You are not in any rush. Namaste.